be here. So y'all gotta excuse me. These shoes is to be cute, not to be studying. So I have two poems, and they're kind of long though. So one of them is a relationship poem. And one of them I think I did the last time I was here. It's kind of like a girl power type thing. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to let you guys decide which one you want to
hear. Girl power.
Yes, Mother's Day weekend is a new girl power.
That's right.
All right, we'll do that again. This is, I think, the second time I'm ever doing this, and I'm doing it here for the second time again. So that's cool. It's called Video Vixen. Listen, I don't want to be a goddamn video vixen, so fuck this new system. Because yes, I'm a grown-ass woman who would rather work than twerk. I still enjoy face-to-face conversations, and the access that make me sexy can't be seen up my skirt, and it hurts that society is looking past the fact that some of us women still possess elegance and class. We aspire to be ladies and mothers to our babies, and it's crazy. See, as a woman, I feel like it's time to take a stand, because I can't even comprehend why the times that we live in cause for me to defend my option not to bend and to cover up the skin that I live in.
Yeah.
I'm tired of having to explain why I decided to put my knowledge on blast, the shit that I learned in class instead of my ass or my ass pass, yeah. And it's sad because I'm gonna laugh. Because I've done that. Yeah. So I figured, at least half of this generation is going to die of hunger. Because no longer are we experiencing those mouth-watering smells from the kitchen, because all of our sisters are too big and bad bitches and video vixens to go in the kitchen and buy some goddamn chicken.
That's right. Look at you right now.
Come on, girl.
So no, you won't catch me on Snapchat in a snapback, sitting on the sink that makes my ass look fat, in a matching bra set with my makeup looking flawless, hashtag guy gave me all this, trying to snag a rap artist. Why is this shit so widely accepted? And why is real women like myself constantly neglected? No. These chicks are not my ideal of perfection. See, I don't understand what is so appealing about the vixens, and I could be tripping, but the three B's just don't define me. Booty, bundles, and deals is not my cup of tea. Okay. So shout out to the women not out here trying to be what you see on TV, those queens that are too busy catching blessings to be catching STDs. And I ain't gonna lie. Hold on. When I found out how much the Kardashians was worth, I wanted to give it a shot. But sucking community dick just to get a lick of fame is not my main thing. Plus, as a woman of substance, I can't maintain being vain. I was born to be a queen.
Yes.
I came into this world with a mind full of dreams, dreams to change the world. So no, I don't want to be just another video vixen or another video girl. I want to change the world.
That's right.
I want the world to look at me and see self-respect. And respect the neck that I had to break to get to the top. And not the neck that I had to throw or the ass that I had to pop. I want to be a woman that is known for doing big things instead of a woman that is always on the scene. And to all of you vixens and bad bitches in here, I'm not trying to be mean, but damn, is there any room left in this world for us queens? Can we scam your Instagrams with pictures of our graduations without you losing patience? Can we broadcast our sorority sisters giving back on your Snapchats? Can we show you how our face looks on your Facebooks without so much fucking cleavage in the picture? And my sisters, can we love those men that you didn't understand and place in the zone of friend? Because yes, some of our sisters want to be vixens, but listen, some young girls still dream of growing up to be queens. And to those young girls, I say, you'll always be supreme.
Yeah.
Hold on to what you believe and don't believe all that you see, because the only thing better than a woman with a fat ass is a queen with a dream.
All right.